Good afternoon, everybody. And it's wonderful to be here. Very grateful to Dr. Unni and Dr. Manoj for the invitation. And after this, I'll be going on to a topic from the structure and anatomy. We'll go into a little bit of function. And the question in front of us is MacTel blue light sensitive? And the problem statement, fundus changes in MacTel clinically can be subtle at times, and the areas on FFA which we see are much larger than what we find clinically. So is there a way to non-invasively diagnose, confirm, and please note, reconfirm. I say reconfirm because I'll tell you why reconfirm, but reconfirm this disease. So it was found that blue light reflectance imaging using the confocal SLO of the Heidelberg system at a wavelength of 488 nanometers proved to be a very promising, rapid, and non-invasive diagnostic tool in MacTel type 2. What does it show? It shows the characteristic oval parafoveal area of increased hyperreflectance, which is surrounded by a rim of lower reflectance. And this is larger than the area even which is seen on the late phase of FFA and correlates well to zone of pigment loss, which is pathognomic. So let's just see the original work, which is done by Dr. Peter Issa. And the first article was published in ACTA in 2008. And if you see the angiography here, and when you see the blue reflectance, you see in both the cases shown how beautifully it's seen in a non-invasive manner. And this was followed up by a larger series from in the same group published in IOVS. And again, we can see the confocal blue reflectance beautifully in this patient. So the loss of the macular pigmentation has been proposed to cause this observation on the BLR, but the exact basis is still unclear. As we know, MacTel is an enigma for all of us. And then the very important article Dr. Catherine is one of the publishers from the Mofields group, the MacTel study group. And they studied also this reflectance using shortwave wavelength light for this disease. And they found that these new imaging modalities have revealed the neurodegenerative signs of the disease and would help us hypothesize its pathogenesis. So basically, what they found is the vast majority with early disease. So this was important because they were picking up early disease. And the well-defined area on the basis of hyperreflectance is seen on the blue light also, and a deficit of pigment, as well as something called dual wave autofluorescence. And they saw that both were equally sensitive. But unfortunately, we don't have much access to DWAF. So they found that blue light is more useful because it is commonly used in our clinics. So let's go on to a few examples. So I think one of the advantages of this conference is we look back at our images, and I found that our blue reflectance images were really, really bad. So this is a beautiful big artifact, and I'm ashamed to say this is another patient. And here you can kind of make it out if you know what I mean, but it's not very clear. So I had to look for help. So Unni was there to help me, and I would like to thank him and Dr. Shira Arun, who lent me some of these images. And here you can see the color, multicolor, and how beautifully you can see the lesion on the blue reflectance on the right, and another patient where, again, you can see the temporal area, the hyper, beautifully on blue reflectance. This is another patient. We can see some changes of diabetic retinopathy, microaneurysms, nothing much seen on multicolor, but the blue reflectance shows it all beautifully. We are fortunate Dr. Avinash Patange and his group have described a very novel sign in MacTel, and so he just told us in his talk, where they continuously put an indirect ophthalmoscope, and clinically they found that if you see these images, these are the top one was initial, and after the light exposure, these were the images. And after dark adaptation, you found that again, this whitening, this halo comes back. So again, I think the group with Dr. Catherine in it combined these two modalities. So they found the effect of dark adaptation on the blue light reflectance. And beautifully, this has been published in 2018 Retina. And they found that this increased parafoveal reflectance in BLR naturally becomes less obvious with photobleaching. And they found this was important for the grading and diagnosis. So this is what I said. So if the clinician has a doubt whether it exists or not, placing the patient in the dark for 10 minutes helps in decision making and could help in the reconfirmation of MacTel. So these are important for concepts for the pathogenesis. They indicate the abnormal metabolic handling of the luteal pigment, which is widespread in the macula, even in early disease. And it has, of course, been shown by previous speakers also that the Müller cells are involved in the disease process. So conclusion, since alterations in type 2 MacTel can be detected in early disease stage using confocal blue refractance, this will be helpful in the early detection of the disease. Thank you very much.